Black holes only seem to come in two radically different sizes. They're either around 5 to 100 times the mass of our sun, what are called stellar mass black holes, or they're millions to billions of times more massive than our sun, aptly named supermassive black holes. So what is going on here? Where are all the in-between sized black holes? And why does the scale range stop there? Could black holes be really tiny or even, as new research suggests, stupendously large? You may remember when the Large Hadron Collider was first coming online, some alarmists claimed it would create a black hole that would destroy the Earth. While microscopic black holes seem far-fetched, there are some theoretical ways they could exist, but you'd need extra dimensions to do it. Gravity, as we know it, isn't strong enough to compress subatomic particles small enough to make them collapse into a black hole, because that size is smaller than the smallest meaningful measurement of distance, the Planck length. If discovered, microscopic black holes would change our understanding of how gravity works at the quantum scale, and even imply the existence of extra dimensions that amplify gravity's force. So, microscopic black holes could be made in particle accelerators, but they would also exist for only the briefest of moments, decaying in an octillionth of a nanosecond. Not exactly enough time to devour the entire planet. So, if they do exist, they're nothing to lose sleep over. Stellar mass black holes, though, are very much real, and we have a pretty solid understanding of how they form. When large stars run out of fuel, they collapse and go supernova. If the core they leave behind is more than about 3 solar masses, the star's remnants collapse in on themselves, and a black hole is born. These black holes can grow by devouring nearby material or merging with neutron stars or other black holes. You might imagine if a stellar mass black hole was allowed to just keep accumulating matter, eventually it would balloon to the size of the supermassive black holes that we think are at the center of almost all large galaxies. But there's an upper limit to how fast matter can fall into a black hole, so growing that large would take billions of years. Since we've observed black holes with billions of solar masses that formed within hundreds of millions of years of the Big Bang, something else must be at work. The mechanism for how supermassive black holes come to be is one of the great mysteries of astronomy. There are a few competing ideas, each with their own strengths and weaknesses. For example, maybe they formed from large seed black holes that are already very massive when they form, and then they continue to grow as they suck in matter. These large seeds would be the remnants of stars as big as 250,000 solar masses. Stars that large should be rare, making large seeds less likely. Another idea is they're the product of several intermediate-sized black holes. These intermediate-sized black holes could form in dense star clusters as stars collide. After formation, they sink toward the center of a galaxy where they merge. As I said before, though, there seems to be a gap in the sizes of black holes. There is very little evidence that intermediate-sized black holes exist. Beyond supermassive black holes, there could be even more jumbo cosmic pits. One recent suggestion is there could be black holes larger than a trillion solar masses, more than 10 times larger than even the very biggest black hole we've discovered. The researchers who proposed their existence dubbed them stupendously large black holes. Even our explanations for supermassive black holes wouldn't account for these giants. Their existence would require us to rethink how black holes form. Or maybe there just is an upper limit to how big black holes can get. Black holes could run the gamut from the microscopic to the mind-meltingly massive, but so far, the only thing we know for sure is they exist in two size ranges, and we're not even certain how the larger size is possible. There's no doubt scientists are going to keep probing for black holes at all scales, because black holes have not only captured light, but our imaginations too. You might think that stupendously large black holes are the result of when supermassive black holes combine, but something called the final parsec problem makes their merger impossible. Check out my video on that here. All right, wild hypothesis time. Where do you think all the intermediate-sized black holes are? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.